Motion EMS, we are done, right? You have any doubts? Like if you have done anything like that? This you haven't done EMI yet.
No, I did that and I just started.
No doubts on EMI.
Okay, so next we'll do is AC generator.
AC generator is a device that converts magnetism into electricity. Fine. So it's a very useful device. Like what we discussed last class, it is very easy to generate magnetic field. You can, you know, have a huge amount of magnetic field, and if you have a device that converts magnetism into electricity, that's like one of the greatest invention of all. And this is that one of that invention. Okay. So the construction of this AC generator is something like this. You might have seen this in class 10th also. There is North Pole, South Pole. You know, right, the coil will rotate and you have north and south poles which suppose creates a uniform magnetic field B. Fine. A uniform magnetic field B is created. This coil can rotate with omega angular speed. Its area is A. Fine. Right now the coil is kept like this. Getting it? Coil is like this. Find out the flux through the coil initially, how much it is.
I should have drawn while I was drawing it. Why you waited for me?
How much is the flux?
BA.
BA, right? The area is like this. Magnetic field is crossing this area. So B into A. And if this has number of turns as capital N, the total flux will be N B into A. This is initially, but this coil is rotating. Suppose this coil rotates little bit after time t, how much will be the rotation? Theta will be omega t. Omega t, right? So angle between area and magnetic field will become how much after time t? Omega t. Right now it is zero. So that is why B dot A is N B A. After time t, it becomes omega t angle. So the flux will become NBA cos of omega t. Isn't it? Right? So EMF will be what? Minus of d phi by dt. This is equal to NBA omega sine omega t. Okay, so you are not changing magnetic field, you are not changing area of the coil. What you are doing, you are changing only angle between area and the magnetic field, and you are able to generate EMF out of it. Fine. So the current through this coil will be E by R. This is the resistance R. This NBA into omega is magnitude of the voltage that is created. Fine. Can you draw with time the value of flux? How it will vary? This is flux. N is constant, B is constant, A is constant. It's a cos graph with time. How the cos graph looks like?
Starts from
it will be like this. This is how flux varies. Okay? How the EMF will vary? It's a sine graph.
Yeah.
So it goes like this. Okay. So when flux is maximum, EMF is minimum. And when EMF is maximum, flux is minimum. So this is just a basic introduction of AC generator. This actually tells you that you don't need to vary only magnetic field or area. You can change the angle also and you will be able to generate the EMF. Okay. Right? Okay, so let us start the next topic. This is inductance. Have you heard of inductance before? Have you heard of inductance? What comes to your mind when you hear inductance? Capacitance. Capacitor is used to store what? Capacitor is used to do what?
Store charges.
Store charges and electrostatic energy. Inductor or inductance is a device to store magnetic energy. Right? Write down inductor or inductance. Stores the magnetic energy. Now you have found out capacitance, like how? You assume that a capacitor is given a charge Q and whatever is the potential difference, if you can write in terms of, if you write this equation Q is equal to some constant into V, then this constant of proportionality becomes the capacitance. Fine. This is how you quantify the capacity of the capacitor. You supply the charge and look at what is the potential difference. If potential difference is high, it means that its capacity is less. It's like you take a bucket, you pour 1 liter of water. If height difference is very high, it immediately picks the height. It means capacity is less. Similarly, in capacitance, you put the charge in it. If potential difference rises to a larger degree, the capacity should be less. Getting it? So without increasing its potential to a large degree, it is able to store a lot of charge. That is what capacitance actually means. And it is nothing but a constant capacitance. Fine. So capacitance also in a way tells you that how much energy you can store. Fine. Now when it comes to magnetic energy, inductance, what is the cause of the magnetic energy? The basic cause of magnetic energy or magnetism, what it is? A dipole?
Yeah.
A dipole, right? And the basic, the most basic dipole is electron revolving in the orbit. Fine. And counterpart of that in real life is a loop. Fine. Or you can just say a current is the cause of magnetism. Fine. So suppose you supply current I to any structure, fine, and it gives away some magnetic flux, okay, in the loop, okay, then the constant of proportionality here, this is inductance. If you have to supply less amount of current to get huge amount of flux, it means that capacity is large. You are able to generate lot of magnetic energy with less current. Fine. So it is, there is no other logic other than this, that you know that okay, current can be the cause of magnetic energy and flux can be the effect of magnetic energy. It can denote magnetic energy. So just like that, I mean the constant proportionality between the flux and the current is assumed to be inductance. Fine. Now once we have studied the capacitance, this is the generic definition of capacitance. Whatever structure, you put the charge Q, measure the potential, constant of proportionality is capacitance. After that, what we did, we found out capacitance of some basic structures. And the first one was parallel plate capacitor. Fine. So now we have definition of inductance. We will try to find out inductance of few basic things. Are you getting it? So, but then the way this inductance is defined, it can be slightly different from the way capacitance is defined, because the flux in one coil can be due to its own current and can also be because of the adjacent current. Isn't it? You have a coil like this and another coil like that. If this coil has a current, even this coil will have flux. This coil doesn't have a current in it. Getting it? So without having current, this coil can have flux. So this current may not be of the coil itself. Fine? So the inductance is defined in two ways. One is self-inductance. When you define the self-inductance, you measure the flux in the first coil in terms of current in that coil itself, and you call that as self-inductance. You represent it by L. Okay, this is self-inductance definition. When the flux is because of its own current, then you say that is due to its self-inductance. Getting it? But if you see that there can be flux because of, let's say, adjacent current or I2. So this I2 is able to create magnetic energy on the first coil. Second coil current is creating magnetic energy on the first coil. Fine. So the concept of proportionality is called mutual inductance. This is mutual inductance. Fine. And mutual inductance, how many mutual inductances are possible? Can be as many, right? Because this one coil, this can have flux because of all the adjacent coils. So between this and this, there will be a mutual inductance. Between that and this, there will be mutual inductance. Between this and two, between 5 and 2, between 6 and 2, between 7 and 2. So every pair has a mutual inductance. Even these two have mutual inductance. But right now my focus is this with respect to every other thing. Fine. So when you try to write down the total flux in the coil, you can write it like this. L into I1 plus M12 into I2 plus M13 into I3 and so on. In our syllabus, we will be dealing mostly with just two coils. So you'll have LI1 plus N12I2. Okay. What if I find out this flux in the second coil because of the current in the first coil? You'll get M21. Getting it? These two will be same. Flux in the second coil due to the current in the first coil. This constant proportionality will be same as this one. Mutual inductance will be same. Whether you find flux due to the first on the second or flux due to the second on the first. The mutual inductance will be same. Mutual inductance will be same. Self-inductance will be different. Self-inductance is its own property. Mutual inductance is the mutual property. Fine. So now we will try to find out self-inductance and mutual inductances of some, you know, routine geometries. Just like capacitance depends on only its geometry, shape and size, similarly inductance also depends on its geometry, shape and size. Fine.